Today's lesson is multiplying radicals with different indices. When the radicands are the same and the indices are different. Example, the square root of 3 times the cube root of 3. The radicand here is 3 and the radicand here is 3. So the radicands are the same. It is understood the index here is 2 and then the index here is 3. So the indices are different. To multiply this, just follow this rule. The m root of a times the n root of a is equals to m times n and then a raised to m plus n. So just multiply this index by this index and then a raised to m plus n. Let's follow this. So we have 2 times 3 and then 3 raised to 2 plus 3. So this is now equal to 2 times 3 is 6 and then 3 raised to 2 plus 3. So 3 raised to 5. Then multiply 3 by itself 5 times. 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is equal to 243. So this is now equal to the 6th root of 243. When the radicands are different and the indices are also different. Example, the square root of 2 times cube root of 6. The radicand here is 2, the radicand here is 6, so the radicands are different. It is understood the index here is 2 and then the index here is 3, so the indices are different. To multiply this, just follow this simple rule. The m root of a times the nth root of b. Just multiply the index of the first by the index of the second. That will be the index of the product. And then a for the radicand, a raised to the index of the second times b raised to the index of the first. So we have now 2 times 3. So multiply the index of the first by the index of the second. And then 2 raised to the index of the second. So 2 cubed. Then 6 raised to the index of the first. So 6 squared. Then just simplify. 2 times 3 is 6. Then 2 cubed is 8. 6 squared is 36. 36 times 8. 6 times 8 is 48, so carry 4. 8 times 3 is 24 plus 4 is 28. So this is equal to the 6th root of 288. Example number 3. The cube root of x times the 5th root of y. The radicand here is x, the radicand here is y, so the radicands are different. The index here is 3, the index here is 5, so the indices are different. Again, follow the rule. Multiply the index of the first by the index of the second to get the index of the product. And then the radicand of the first raised to the index of the second times the radicand of the second raised to the index of the first. Following the rule, we have 3 times 5, and then x raised to the index of the second, so x raised to the exponent of 5, and then y raised to the index of the first, so y cubed. Then we have 3 times 5 is 15, so we have the 15th root of x raised to the exponent of 5, y cubed. Example number 4. The cube root of x raised to the exponent of 5 times the 4th root of x cubed. The radicand here is x raised to the exponent of 5, and the radicand here is x cubed. So the radicands are different. The index here is 3, the index here is 4, so the indices are also different. Again, follow this rule. Multiply the index of the first by the index of the second to get the index of the product. And then the radicand of the first raised to the index of the second times the radicand of the second raised to the index of the first. Let us follow the rule. So 3 times 4, and then x raised to the exponent of 5 raised to 4 times x cubed raised to 3. Then follow this rule. X raised to the exponent of m raised to n is equals to a raised to m times n. So we are going to multiply 5 by 4 and then 3 by 3. So this is now equal to 3 times 4 is 12, and then x raised to 20 times x raised to 9. This is now equal to the 12 root of x raised to the exponent of 29, because we add the exponents in multiplication. 20 plus 9 is 29. Now this can be written as the 12 root of x raised to the exponent of 24 times the 12 root of x raised to the exponent of 5. Anyway, 24 plus 5 is 29. We are doing this so that we can divide 24 by 12. We are going to follow this rule. The nth root of a raised to m is equal to a raised to m divided by n. So divide the exponent to the radicand a by the index. So we are going to divide 24 by 12. So this is now equal to x squared, because 24 divided by 12 is 2. And then 12 root of x raised to the exponent of 5. So the answer is x squared 12 root of x raised to the exponent of 5.